Calm the fuck down.
Calm the fuck down.
With David and Erin.
With David and Erin.
Nope. Today's word, the word for today is fuck no.
It's goodbye.
I wait for her to come back. Erin, the door is open.
Oh God, thanks.
Yeah. I'm livid. I am pissed. I don't know about, I know you're all happy and peppy and bursting with love.
I'm so fucking happy today.
Well,
yeah.
I don't know. We haven't had a chance to talk.
Well,
much.
No, you dragged me in here off the street really fast. I'm missing a shoe, and you're like, sit down. Want to do a podcast today?
You know, wouldn't that be funny if it was funny? It's not.
Oh.
I woke up. Well,
that's
I made
a good thing you woke up.
Well, I didn't think I was gonna. You ready?
What did you do, David?
I made a mistake last night, and okay. All right. You know me. I like my Prosecco. I like to have my... And I haven't been drinking... Shut the fuck up. I haven't been drinking a lot lately. Because the pill, my gene therapy pill, it's done a weird thing. Just for my wanting. But the past couple of days have been like the worst days of my life.
You needed
yes.
a drink, honey.
Personally.
Right.
Yes. And so last night... After we took our walk, and we did our, we spoke, and I came back and worked on the show with some of the commercials you wrote. You write 99% of them.
I have so much fun though.
You do, and I come in though, and I fix them and make them funny.
You mean you add fuck, cock, and balls to my
yes,
things? Yes,
because it's like reading obituaries. Your commercials are like reading that this is it. Sally's dead. Blah 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 blah. And then I come in and say, Sally died with a dildo up her ass. And this here at dildos up your ass, we'll take care of your recently bereaved and pop those babies out.
Huh.
Anyway, so last night, 10 o'clock, 10 p.m., I take my pill, my gene therapy pill, Tagrisso.
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 It's not DiGiorno. It's not delivery.
No, okay. It's not Grey Poupon.
Mm-mm.
So I believe I took at 10 my pill with a little slip of Progresso. Yeah, I opened up a can of soup and I just drank from it, cut my lip, went to the emergency room.
And they had your liquor in the Progresso soup.
In the Progresso soup.
That's fantastic.
They're Italian. Anyway, my Prosecco. Okay, not 4 minutes later, I look at Jeff and say, I don't think I took my pill. I don't think I took my pill. And I took another one. So I took two of my gene therapy pill that, you know, I break out in the fucking itchiest rash in the world. I get incredibly exhausted. Okay. Within a half hour, I don't think I vaguely remember looking at Jeff and going, I need to go to bed now.
No.
And I went upstairs and I was out. Now, all night, of course, I'm dreaming of dying because it's in the back of my mind. Now, my husband read, he went online and read the Tagrisso. You know, side, blah, 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 blah. And it said, you know, the dosage I take is one pill, but other people take two. And depending upon the
severity,
severity of their cancer. So while I'm up there dreaming of dying, he's looking and going, oh, it's fine. it just says the side effects may intensify, but it'll only last a day. And so here I am looking at you Snow fell yesterday. We have maybe an inch of snow, but the pool guys are still pooling away. They're doing their job.
Is that a bench? What the fuck am I looking
at? No, I thought it was a hibachi. Do you know that? Are you thinking of the same thing?
I guess so. I'm looking out the window and there's this thing on the little hill. It looks like a bench. I've never
I thought
seen.
It was a hibachi.
So you went right for the food.
I did. Because I thought it's a big grill. It's a big grill.
Well, last time they
made their own
in
fire.
A hole.
Yes. Yes.
They dug a fucking hole and
they
made
fucking. They are Mexicans and Mexican Americans. And I loved that they cooked their own meals.
They put a whole like rib rack on there. It's like, we'll be back in 7 hours to fix it.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. That was like fucking Romanian.
Yeah.
What you just said.
Really Mexican.
They're going to be back. Viva la Putin.
I can't do it.
Uh-uh.
Oh, I don't want to talk about Putin.
No, let's not. But anyway, no, you know what that is? That is the back end of a lift.
Is that the back of a hoe?
That would be you.
I'm the front, honey. I ain't no back end.
You're the
hoe.
Front, side, and
I
back
am a front end
of a
hoe,
hoe
girl. I'm not
you
the
are
back
a front
end.
In the hoe. I've got a foot in the hoe.
You got a foot in the hoe?
I got
the front
my
of the
foot
hoe.
In the hoe.
You got your foot
I've
in my hoe?
I've got my foot in the hoe.
Ho, 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 ho.
Don't. And I'm not pressing Santa.
Hi, ho. So,
could there are buttons for that?
I don't know where they are.
Yeah,
so.
I know.
I just look, see the one I want to do and go ding dong or.
No,
oh,
or
monkey.
Baby crow. Okay, shut up. So that's my malady this morning.
Okay.
If I could have slept in till Thursday. Wait, today is Thursday.
Yeah. Good morning, honey.
Oh, good. Look how fucked up I am. To Friday, I would have. I would have. So I'm a little spooked, but then Jeff tells me this morning, hey, don't worry, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, where's the butcher knife so I can kill you? I'm dreaming of dying upstairs.
Would you have wanted him to wake you?
Don't laugh. Yes.
Yeah, you
no,
would
no, no,
have.
No, 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 no.
No, no, no,
shut,
no. You shut the
no,
fuck
you,
up.
I wasn't going to say
you
fuck.
You would
dirty.
Have been so fucking pissed. I was sleeping and my alarm is set for 9:12 and I have 9 more hours to sleep.
When do I ever
sound? You could have told me that in the morning.
Who the
Those
fuck?
Are all the things you would have said.
When have you ever seen me asleep in my bed at night? N-E-V-E-R.
Inaccurate.
You've never seen me sleeping in my
bed. I've seen you sleeping in the morning in your bed.
When? What the fuck are you're freaking me out.
Okay,
now.
I came upstairs and we talked. I was at the foot of your bed and Alex came once up and scared the crap out of you.
No, he didn't. What scared the crap out of me is he spoke to me. Number one, no one's allowed upstairs.
Really?
That is our sanctuary.
It's a big open
bedroom.
Loft.
Yes, yes. It's gorgeous. And no one, that's why there's a security dog. No.
Sure.
That German Shepherd we only hire from 9 to 5 to make sure people, you don't come into our homosexual inner sanctum. Mm-hmm.
I have been. I offered to cuddle.
Oh, no, that I would do with you. Yeah. But we've been through this. I won't go behind you in case I get erect and poke you in the back.
Yeah, so we just don't
spoon. We just don't, no. Yeah, we hold hands occasionally.
Sometimes we skip.
We skip. We just skip. We definitely skip. But your hands get sweaty.
They do not.
They do so.
Do they?
No.
Oh.
I just did that to be mean to
that
you.
That was hurtful, actually.
I know. That's the mood I'm in. I am in such a, well.
You know what? It reminds me of when I forget to take my pills, too. And I look down and I'm like, I look down every night and go, today. And I say it out loud because I figure if I'm wrong, my husband,
correct,
who loves to correct me when I'm wrong,
yep,
will be like, air. So I'm like, today is Wednesday. And
correct.
He'll be like, no, today's Friday. And I'll be like, well, I haven't taken my pills in 3 days then. Should
you
I just take them all now?
Do you know, because of you doing that? I swear to God, I do dream of that. I told you I've been having these terrible, terrible death dreams with cancer.
Yes.
Terrible. That I think I mentioned this. I don't know if I did. That I dreamt that I hadn't taken my pill in 2 weeks.
And then you didn't.
And
then you
couldn't
overtook
find
two.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What are you saying? I have a suicide wish?
No. It's like you weirdly corrected yourself for no reason, though.
Yeah, there's got to be a better way if Prosecco is involved. Where I, you know what I need to do? Don't laugh at me. I need to just be, say out loud, I'm taking my pill. Here I go. Woo, woo,
why can't you get the thing like I have where it's every night of the week instead of leaving it in the jar?
Number one, the pill cannot cohabitate with any other
pill. I didn't tell you to. You can get the one for the nighttime and just put, like mine says, has green for the day and purple for night.
Yes, I have that for my antidepressant.
So just keep one upstairs that, or just one with the days of the week on it.
No, it's at 10 o'clock and it's in the kitchen.
Then put it in one of those things still. So every day you look and go, okay.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
God, you're such a bitch.
All right, no, you know what, you whore little cow.
Trying to be nice.
You know what?
I'm like a 5-year-old. Go ahead.
I'm trying to give you comp. No, I'm not going to
do it.
No, you whore. I'm not. No. You're a dirty, dirty, stinking.
I thought you said you weren't going to give me a compliment.
Well, folks, thanks for listening. And
I feel like a 5-year-old. I sit on the edge of the bed and I'm like, today is Monday. And then I'm quiet, like, right? Is Monday?
And I can now, I have that little single pill thing. I have it. I will put my pill in it each morning.
Mm-hmm.
And when I take it, when I see that is empty,
you'll know. Yep.
I will know I have taken my gene therapy pill.
Oh, you know what?
Thank you. Thank you.
You really have come
full circle.
No,
you know, it's nice that I think of things like this.
I'm proud of you.
I'm so happy that I thought of that idea. I really am.
I mean, you should. It's been a while since you had an idea. So it's good to be thoughtful of one.
Welcome to Erin's fabled land, where she thinks up things that aren't true.
Oh.
Like, well, it's nice that you had a thought that was able... I can't get it out because I'm going to start choking on my own spit again.
I have something I'd like to discuss when you're done, okay?
Go ahead.
No,
you're going to bring it down? You're going to bring the fucking party down like with dead babies? Dead baby? Alice Cooper, Dead Babies. What a fucking great song. I was such an Alice Cooper freak when I was a kid.
I can see that about you.
Oh, I loved
long
him.
Long hair?
No, I didn't have long hair. I was a Catholic. I could never go to his concerts because they were demonic, you know. And at the end of each concert, he would guillotine himself. He'd cut his head off.
Nice.
But I bought those fucking albums, and my mother and my sister was pregnant. Oh my God, I am bringing back.
You're bringing the party down.
And I played Dead Babies. Dead Babies! Oh my God, I loved Alice. Oh, and he had a guitarist that I just wanted that man to call me baby.
Bay.
No, not like that. That sounded like a goat getting fucked. Do it again.
Baby.
That is.
Speaking of goats getting fucked.
Yes. That's a chimpanzee.
Yeah, I'd like to say something.
Go ahead. Goat ahead.
So now, I did come to find that this is actually not true, but I'm going to talk about it anyway because I found it humorous.
Uh-oh.
We get this email notification on like dumb news and things, you know?
Yeah, yes, yes.
And it says...
We call spam.
Spain...
Okay.
Has turned over their rules on bestiality, and it is now legal to engage in bestiality.
Is this true?
Well, okay, you clearly don't fucking pay attention. I started out by saying, I thought this was actually true, but it turns out it's not, but it's still funny anyway.
Well, see, it's no. You see, you suck addiction. Suck addiction.
Nobody's told me ever that before.
Suck addiction.
You suck addiction.
Suck addiction.
Suck a thesaurus.
Suck. Suckabertania.
Oh.
Wait a minute.
Anyway.
It said Spain has now legalized goat
bestiality.
Fucking. Bestiality.
Then I just thought to myself for a minute, like, how many people in Spain then were getting arrested for, like, fucking the cow or chicken or goat or whatever?
Erie, PA, we always read farmers fuck their cows.
Well, I mean, fine. Listen, I'm not... I have watched a bestiality video because you have to, right? You got to see what the fuck people are talking about. Personally, not my thing.
No.
But I don't judge anybody's sexual thoughts and fantasies because everybody's fucked up. Just nobody wants to talk about it.
What if your son came home today with a goat and said, Mom, Dad, meet Billy.
Hi, Billy Goat, Billy.
Yeah, meet Billy. And the goat looks at you and goes, hello.
I think that was fucking awesome. I bet you want to hang out and watch TV. Now,
we're going up to his room.
Have a good time. I stay out of
and
my business.
And then you'd hear hoof pounding.
I mean, listen, you, again, to each their own, okay? But I'm just thinking, like, how many people got arrested and went to court?
Yes.
And the courts were like, we're just fucking so packed up with all these fucking goat fuckers.
Yeah.
We got to just make this legalized already. We can't handle this in the courts. And they were like, overturned.
I'm worried now about eating char. That's goat cheese.
Why are you worried about it?
Because it's got Farmer John's semen in it.
I don't think the cheese has that in it.
Well, where do you think the jizz goes?
Not in their
where
udders.
Where the fuck does the jizz go?
Not in their udders. Where does the
udders?
Cheese go?
Where it goes to the udders?
I'm going to have to mark this number down and tell my family not to listen to this podcast.
Like they listen. Like they lie to you.
I know.
Do you know what they do every single fucking night?
What?
They call me. And they say, is Kerrigan done writing the run of show? And I look, I say, yep. They say, let us read it. Okay, we don't have to listen.
Yeah.
And it's being pushed by your mother.
Yeah, I don't.
Your mother says she's busy. She's a busy behaving gal in California.
Yeah.
And she's got shit to do. She got his shit to do.
She's never had time for my shenanigans, that lady.
And she said, honey, I gave birth to the bitch, okay? Wait. I goated that baby.
I don't want to. I love my dad, but
I left him out.
I know. My brother yesterday, we're going to see my parents next week, and I don't see them often.
They're coming here next week?
Yeah.
That means they're coming here next week.
They love coming here.
I know.
Anyway, so.
Oh, look at that. Look what's in my calendar. James. Jeff and I are gone all next week.
That's why you're renting the house out to them while you're gone.
Oh, look at that. We're here.
You said.
Nope.
Anyway, so I'm not going to bring up the story because I don't want to piss
anybody
off.
Well, then you started it.
I'm ending it.
You're not going to tell the story that I don't even know what you fucking are talking about?
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you get sequels.
Boy,
keep the listeners
let me tell you
listening.
Something. You must have had some shit on your father then. You had to have some embarrassing fucking shit that I've never seen you back away from a story.
Yeah.
You know what I realized? I'm looking at these two William Morris lights we have up here.
Like anybody's going to fucking know about your special fancy lights and your fancy
fucking. People
know
William Morris.
Shiitake table out there that
it's
you got.
It's not a shiitake table. It's a stickly table. Shiitake table. Now, one of the bulbs are out. You can see the difference in the light. And those things are a bitch to take down.
It's like me and you. One's really bright and one's not so shining over there. Huh. Oh.
Welcome again to Erin's fantasy world, where she says things that just aren't true. Cricket fucking here! Cricket fucking here!
Cricket cupcakes.
See, that's not funny. I laughed just because I felt bad for you. I did. No, I laughed because I thought, you know what? She's
poor
pathetic.
Thing.
She's pathetic.
She needs something.
Let's just laugh at her. Okay.
Okay.
No. Why? No. It doesn't matter. Okay. So you're not going to tell the story.
No, I'm not. Can we move on?
Sure.
Okay. What do you now?
I'm furious.
Okay. You still mad?
I am so furious at the stupidity of people in America.
Oh, this is going to be a while.
I mean, the world is gone mad.
Oh, fuck.
The world is, what's the matter?
Nothing. Go ahead.
What did you do? You forgot something.
I did, but it's so stupid and unnecessarily important.
Not about the show.
No, and I don't even, it just came, it's just, you.
It came to you in a vision.
I forgot to do something and it's not a big deal. It really wasn't, and I don't even know why it just.
You just talked about
now.
Your pills.
You forgot. I'm forgetting things.
Did you
I
forget
guess.
To pick your kid up from school?
No.
Oh my God.
No. No.
Who?
It's 11:30.
What the fuck?
What the fuck are you doing to me?
I am furious at the stupidity of this world.
Bring it on, sister.
This stupid, dumb bitch,
oh, no.
Marjorie Taylor Greene, standing with those fucking teeth. Where did she get them? From Hasbro? Are they Lego?
I was just gonna say they're Lego dentures.
Yeah. Those fucking teeth. And I'm calling for a separation of the blue and the red. And this country needs to be divorced. And the incredible response of, you dumb shit, Lincoln took care of that, and you lost. Oh. No.
Sorry.
See, I'm carrying this rant on, even if a commercial is being pushed in my fucking desk.
I didn't even notice.
We're going to do this. So fuck the world.
Woo! Hello, ladies. It's me, your pal, Frumpkin.
Hi, Frumpkin.
Hi, honey. Hi, honey. And I'm here to discuss something that's kind of taboo, but you know what, we ladies, we have to endure it. Uh-huh. I think you know what I'm talking about? That time of the month.
Yes.
Oy vey. The shopping at the grocery store and having a package of maxi pads or tampons in your cart. And like it's other people's businesses, you have to worry what people are thinking when they look at your cart? Fuck that. You got your period. You know, please, some privacy. And if that isn't bad enough, you have to spend the entire time wandering with cramps and you're running late for work.
Ah!
You okay, honey? That's okay. So what happens now? Your tampon string gets caught in your zipper and oi! What a mess of luck. Enough is enough, ladies, and I've had it. I have come up with a new revolutionary method for that time of the month.
Your period!
Yes, that's right, honey. Could you believe it? From me, your pal Frumpkin. I have a new female product with its own app on your phone called Phone Ponds. Yes, Phone Ponds. My custom-sized panties are equipped with 6 reusable, we'll talk about that later, ladies, stringless tampons that are connected to the app. And once your phone has been programmed to your cycle and your time hits, it will pop a tampon right in your coochie and you're set to go. No muss, no fuss. We monitor your days and keep track of your flow, allowing us to know exactly when to remove it. You'll get a notification on your phone, and all you do is simply click the button that says eject, and bam, your tampon comes flying out of your vagina at warp speed, shooting into a custom-made cloth pouch in your new Frumpkin panties with no string.
Wow!
Yes, it's exciting, and it's simple. It's also sanitary, and once removed, you simply toss it in the washer with your next delicate load. Frumpkin Foam Ponds. It's a great product. I promise. No strings attached.
Okay. Let me just say something.
Wait, let me get my phone app out.
You fucking tell me that I put dicks and pussies and everything else into commercials.
Yeah.
Okay. Baby cakes, that was yours.
Yes.
You have
Did I say pussy?
Nuclear, no.
Or dick
coochie.
Once. Coochie.
You brought up in my mind a tampon lodged in your vagina.
Yes, but I didn't say have a tampon lodged in your vagina. I led the viewers to understand there's a tampon probably lodged in somebody's vagina every fucking minute of the day.
What do you think I'm thinking of?
You can't fit up there. There's already busy.
And how about when it comes shooting out?
Well, that's right, but I didn't say shooting out of your pussy. All I said was, you know, it's just a very good commercial. And it wasn't me. It's Frumpkin.
I know that. I know.
Don't bring Frumpkin into this.
No, I wouldn't.
She'll come right in here.
No, because she brings that thing.
Well, she has a new sex therapy program, right?
I've heard, yes. She said she's not prepared for it.
Oh, I thought you were going to see her today.
No.
Oh.
She needs music.
Oh,
see,
Frumpkin.
And yeah. She's the demands that fucking woman makes.
She did say she only wanted green M&Ms, and I was like, fuck. Oh. I had to eat all the other ones because what else was I going to do?
What was I talking before your nuclear vagina?
Wait, give me a minute. I'll think about it.
Marjorie Taylor Greene.
And her teeth that look like
teeth.
Legos.
Yeah. She wants to start. And people reminded her, you are a representative in Congress. That's treasonous. Boot her fucking ass. What is the matter with these people?
Well, what's interesting is usually they're willing to be, you know, fucking ridiculous behind closed doors. She was just outwardly saying, hey, let's do stupid
treason
shit.
But she's nuts. Yeah. She's not.
And people vote liking her and stuff.
That the Jews put a satellite to cause wildfires.
And what if we did? Who the fuck are you?
I'm sorry, Mrs.
Do you know how long it took for us to get that fucking menorah and the oil to stay lit?
How about this?
Just kidding.
Don't get me started with this. With the fact that Israel went and pushed into more of Gaza to take more land away from the Palestinians. And 10 Palestinians are dead because the... Ow! Now the monkey would work. You ready for this?
No.
This is how fucked up religion is.
Okay, bring it on.
This is how... Okay. Yesterday, I had to go to our place, Johnston's Toyota.
Johnston's Toyota. Sorry.
I was backing you up. Go for it.
I just don't know the rest of the words.
I've never heard of it.
I just know Johnston's Toyota. Johnston's Toyota. Johnson's Toyota. That's all I know.
That's the Johnson's Toyota special needs.
Do they have a drive-thru?
No. All right.
Okay.
I had to go there. Remember, I had the handle replaced.
Yes, you had the handle replaced.
Well, I also went with swag because I love everybody. They all listen to us. And I took hoodies for
you
everybody.
You did.
I did. And... My main man, Jason, got him his hoodie. And, you know, you walk in and it's just line of cubicles. And they all have their names on it. And they're the nicest people in the world. The nicest people. I don't know who the Mr. Johnston, if he's still around.
Mr. Johnston Toyota. Mr. Johnston Toyota.
He'll drive you crazy. Ha ha. Get it? Crazy driving.
Okay. Yeah. Anyway, what was your story? You just leave the Johnston Toyota song to me. You're not doing it right.
I won't. I will.
Doing it wrong.
So I go in and my buddy Russell, who we just constantly give the finger to each other. And I'm handing them out, and they're loving it. They're having the greatest time. And I said, you guys are just the best. You guys are the best. And I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. Where's Erin? Where's Erin? And I tried to explain to them that...
You keep me contained.
Well, you have to be. You're in an institution, and they let you out. They bring you to this house.
But I need supervision.
Yeah, but I'm not going to... I will not...
Well, you need supervision.
No,
I
won't vouch for
no.
you.
No.
And that's what... Hey... That's what your husband pays for.
Sure.
The supervision of your, what you call, wreck of a life.
Shenanigans.
Well, no.
Shenanigans.
Mentality.
Shenanigans.
No, mental problems.
It's the shenanigans.
Shenanigans. Okay. So now, I'm not going to say if this person is a man or a woman. I'm going to leave it sexless because I don't want to embarrass anybody.
Okay.
But there was one person there.
Named Mark. No, I'm just kidding.
Named Ishka Bibble.
Oh! It's even better.
And I'm giving out the hoods, and I said, hey.
Mark?
No, I'm no sex. Male or female. Oh, no. Marky is a woman's name. You can. There's. Remember that Marky post? Or
oh, God. Just cook. Go ahead, Mark. Marky Mark.
Would you... I'd love to give you any... I blew it. You fucking made me blow it. You fucking blow it. You made me say and he. Okay? Fuck you, Erin. All right.
Fuck so, Mark, really.
No, there is no Mark.
Right,
that
so this is well, perfect.
All right, fine.
Oh,
fuck
God.
You, Mark.
Fuck you, Mark.
So, watch. There's a guy there listening to this now going, I'm Mark.
They just hired Mark, the new guy.
I'm Mark.
Where's my sweatshirt?
Yeah. He looks at me with... absolute, I swear to you, like terror.
Disgust.
No.
Home Alone?
No, it was just like,
don't touch
like
me.
That. Like that. Yeah, yes. And I looked at him and I said, oh, it's because it says fuck. But I said, it's not fuck. It's F hashtag CK. And speechless, not a word. And just backed up and got up. And I said, oh, God, you're religious.
Forgetting yesterday was Ash Wednesday.
I had no idea.
Did he have ashes on his head?
No.
right.
No.
So what'd you find out about Mark?
Well, no.
Well, saying that extra part will point out that person.
Yeah,
so.
It did.
But it was for religious purposes.
It was for religious purposes.
Yeah, which is hey,
and
fuck
wait,
that, right?
This religion does not allow gifts to be given.
Why didn't you just fucking tell him to give you $10 for it then?
No, but I just stood
Mark.
There and I thought, are you fucking telling me you believe in some... It's like Russell and I are the spaghetti monster, the spaghetti pot in the sky. Do you know the spaghetti monster?
On top of spaghetti.
Shut up. No, no.
All right.
Listen to me.
Thought that's what we were doing.
Listen to my words, you were. And now, Flash Gordon and the German princess.
Oh, no, don't make me a German princess.
You're a German princess.
I want to be Flash Gordon.
So anyway, can you believe the act of, I'm giving something joyful. I'm giving something to say thanks. You guys are brilliant here. You're just brilliant. I love you, and Erin and I love you. And some religious dogma prevented him from taking my gift. How fucked in the universe is that?
Well, it seems like even if he took your gift, where would he wear it if he's such a religious person anyway?
But look, that's why I don't. Emily, my buddy Emily over at Dog Mountain Lodge. Dog Mountain Lodge, if you want to have
dog
your dog.
Dog Mountain Lodge.
Ooh, I like that.
Thank you.
That's very 60s. Dog Mountain Lodge. I added the roof.
You should call them and tell them a great
Emily,
deal we'll give
she's
them.
She's a young mother. She's got a kid who I think is... It's not that young. I fucking hate that baby sound. I hate you right now. You are now adding to my fury. I am fury mad.
I don't have a button for that.
All right, shut up. So listen, I said to Emily, I'm not going to give you this because you can't wear this in front of your son, you know, who's 6. Mommy, what's calm the fuck down?
Who's David?
I just... Meanwhile, I'm wearing the hoodie.
I'm looking at it
going, how'd she know I'm David?
She don't wear shirts.
No, and she said, I appreciate that. I love it, but I can never wear it. And I understand that. But for religious purposes, you can't take a fucking gift.
Okay, for fucking starts, you could wear it, just not when you're with your kid. You go out for fucking Friday night with your girlfriend, you put the goddamn sweatshirt
but
on.
If she
Who
wants
cares?
One, yeah, I'll give it to her. But I was just thinking ahead. Do you know what I mean?
Look, I think that everybody has a right to their own ideas and opinions.
Not unless they agree with me.
Well, right. And if they don't, we just walk away, David.
You're right. No, we don't walk away. You know why? Because that's why the Palestinians are dead.
You're right,
and
David.
And the religious, we know what we're talking about. It's the Hasidim. The Orthodox sect is pushing for more land. And Netanyahu, who is on trial now, don't get me started. All right.
Listen, all I was going to say was easy answer was, then motherfucker, give me $10 for the shirt.
Yeah, that's good.
So next time you see Mark, just tell him to give you $10.
But here's how this, you want to know something funny? I'll end it on a funny note.
Well, that'd be nice.
That wasn't a note. That sounded like more pain.
Don't make me look for a button to push. I'm going to look for a button if you don't continue your story. All right. You're asking for
it. Go ahead. Welcome to Erin's Mind, where she makes up shit that no one could possibly believe in. Now, as I was saying...
David.
I'm standing in the line. Now, remember, there's all these cubicles. And I got up. I got a buzz that the door handle is... It's done. It's fixed. So I go over to Danielle, my Danielle, and my Cameron. Am I saying it right? Cameron? It's not
Camry.
Is it
Camry. A car? Camry?
No. Remember, we talked about her, that we think her parents did it in the car. And
so then it's Camry, because that's a Camry. Or Camaro. So, maybe her name's Camaro.
No.
That'd be cooler.
No.
Camaro.
No, her name's Volkswagen. No, her name's Bug.
Her parents were very tiny people.
Well,
they were midgets. They were clowns in a clown car.
And they just came in on Midget Airlines. It's a legitimate thing. It's a legitimate
listen.
Thing. Anyway, look at me. Look at me.
Wait, let me get my glasses.
Look at me. Okay. This is how I sometimes forget. You and I talk on this podcast, and we talk about fucking everything.
Unfortunately, for other people, we do.
Not generally. There's not much to hide.
No.
And I'm with Danielle, and I'm signing, you know, credit card, and I said, honest to God, Danielle, I said, I'm so sorry. I have to go pee. I have to pee so bad. And in this line of cubicles, do you know what someone yelled?
Don't pee out here.
It's a side effect. It's a side effect of my Tagrisso. And I never laughed so hard and felt more vulnerable that they listened and someone yelled, it's a side effect.
Somebody knew something.
Someone
about
knew.
You. That's why I don't go places with you. They'd be like, it's your uterus. I'm staying home.
No, and they all say, where's Erin? And I do say, you're institutionalized.
It's true.
I said, you will never see her.
Nope.
She doesn't like crowds.
Nope.
She doesn't like people.
Nope.
And, oh, nope. No. You got to bring her. We
nope.
want pictures of you guys.
Nope. Nope. Tag me on Facebook.
Nope.
I got a bunch of pictures on there.
Nope. You're coming up.
I'm
no.
adorable.
No, you're not. Yeah, you are. But
thanks.
No, you're coming.
Dick.
You're coming.
No.
Yes, you are.
I'm coming outside 2 feet from my front door.
Oh. And again, I'm sorry I'm going on again about Johnston's. But my
Johnson Toyota. Johnson Toyota. Maybe we got to learn the rest of the song.
No, maybe you do.
I hope that's their song.
What the fuck are we hawking?
I don't know. Anyway.
And my buddy Lori, I swear to you, they're just really nice people.
I'm so glad they're nice
they
to you.
They really are nice, and it was just nice. It was nice.
Well, I'm glad that they're nice too. So shout out to Johnson Toyota. Holla. Johnson's Toyota. Johnson's Toyota. Yeah.
Where
you got there, David.
Your smooth ride is all about us.
Bring us all your broken handles and we'll fix them.
I didn't break it.
Yeah, broke it.
They did. No,
oh,
they saved
they
the deer.
Broke it.
Yes.
Oh, that's right. They said the deer broke it, but
yeah.
they broke it.
No.
Well, whatever.
You know what? I can't follow up with this story because it's so heinous.
Oh, my God.
No, I have to.
I have to.
No, it's just we should do something funny. Let's say goodbye.
Goodbye, David. Say goodbye, Erin. Goodbye, Erin.
Ugh, not funny. Not funny. All right. You know,
fine,
it's time.
You have about 3 minutes to be funny.
Seriously?
Yeah.
3 minutes?
Yeah. And we have another sponsored commercial.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
Hold on. I want to do a name tag. Will you, do you have
you
a name
do
tag?
Do a name tag?
Yeah. Do you have a name tag?
Oh, I'm sure I can find something.
All right. So here we go. Just a moment, please. Okay. If name tags told the truth. Leopold Schmitz, Newark, New Jersey. Okay, let me start again, okay? Leopold Schmitz, Newark, New Jersey orchestra conductor. I wear Depends when I conduct Beethoven's Ninth Symphony and generally pee and shit my way through every performance.
Hello, my name is Dr. Bob. I have no credits, and I've only been here one day. Please drop my pants.
What? Please drop my pants?
I don't know what he's doing. He's being serious. I've never been here. I don't know what's happening. Drop my pants.
Oh, my God. You know...
You're laughing about it.
No,
so it's all right.
No, it is moderately humorous because you're using an analogy backwards.
I liked it.
Drop your pants.
Yes.
Drop my pants. I'm Dr. Bob.
Drop
no
my
credits.
Pants.
Drop
I don't know
my
what
pants.
I'm doing.
Drop
my
pants.
Pants. I'll take it from here.
No, you take it from here.
Oh, no.
All right. How many more minutes do we have?
Too many more. About a minute left.
Oh, okay.
My Fitbit
bitch.
Fit bitch. Wait a minute. That's even better than what I was going to do. You've got a fit bitch.
My fit bitch is telling me I need to walk 276 steps.
Can you do it on your... No, seriously. Sitting there, can no. you move your no. feet like nope. like your
it's the
your cartoon?
It's the whole... And it's connected to your heartbeat underneath.
Can you tell it to shut the fuck up?
Shut the fuck up, you whore.
Hi.
Now I have 210 steps to go.
I'm Bonnie, your fit bitch. Yo, fat ass. You better get up and run.
Yeah, really.
Yeah, well.
I'm going to run. Right. Gonna do a
I'm
going to
finish my... Oh... I'm furious.
Hey, it happens. Well, before you committed the crime that got you all that time, did you ever wonder what you were going to do while locked up in there with all those guys? Huh? Did you? That is a lot of pent-up sexual energy. There's not a lot of things to do in jail, except join a gang, or get stabbed, or both. You got to occupy your time.
Fact! The system was so backed up with complaints from inmates of sexual assault, the penal colony had no choice but to come to our company, Plastic Piece of Pussy, where we provide blow-up dolls in every race, hair color, above and below. And fact! When you visit the commissary, you'll immediately notice our kiosk with pictures of every type of blow-up doll, complete with a rough bush, mouth, and pussy that instantly get wet when you add water to the pre-installed fluid sacs installed in each doll. Fact, no dry nights with these babies.
Blow-up babes for prisoners. You will never have to worry when somebody drops the soap in the shower again. Not when you have one of these buxom, moist baby dolls waiting for you in your cell to blow up.
Fact, they are reasonably priced and most insurance companies will pay a portion of your bill because you won't be dry humping your cellmate who's an accountant that looks like a teenage girl.
Blow up babes for prisoners from Plastic Piece of Pussy Incorporated. Once you've experienced a plastic piece of pussy, you may never go back to the real thing.
Inflate a fuck. Fact. Brought to you by the makers of Soap on a Rope. Fact. We're always looking out for your ass.
Okay, I don't know what that end was.
Inflating
but...
the plastic piece of pussy.
See, mine would be...
No, that was funny because it was the plastic
okay,
sound.
Okay, that frightened me.
Yeah. You just want to get locked up now, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I didn't hear that there was a plastic piece of penis.
I don't know if I mentioned this, but we're watching a show called Better Than Us.
You mentioned the show, but I don't remember what it's about.
I don't know if I mentioned it on here. It's on Netflix. It's about these robots that are made to basically replicate a wife with has empathy feeling for the children,
Megan
all these
three.
Things. Probably, I didn't see Megan 3.
I can't wait.
But I'm assuming something like that. But either way, we've been really...
Did you watch it?
It's a series, so we're still watching it. It's really good.
And they're robots.
They're robots.
But they're robots with humans.
They're robots that are supposed to like make a connection to you and like feel empathy for you and learn you and learn how to be your wife.
Well, that's
learn how to cater to you.
Steven Spielberg.
It's like a
AI.
Hooker. It's like a
artificial.
Hooker.
I love that movie. Artificial intelligence.
Oh.
What?
Sorry.
Steven Spielberg never made a movie called Hookers.
No, he didn't. He made a couple called Poltergeist, though, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 12.
I did
four,
not like
9,
Poltergeist.
12.
Do you know I did not find Poltergeist scary? You know why? This is where you're going to learn about me.
Uh-oh.
To me, there is a movie called, it's Ray Milland. That was actually faggy. I think it's Ray Milland. And I made a Milland. Ray
you
Milland.
Did, you made him Italian.
No, it was Milland. A little homosexual.
I'm
Ray
a truck.
Milland.
I'm a truck.
Ray Milland. And it's called The Uninvited. And it's the spookiest, it's a black and white film in the 40s. It's a spooky motherfucking film. The thing about Poltergeist that I didn't like, you saw everything in color. It was bright. You know what I mean? You know, yeah, there's a big clown coming at me. I can see it.
But if they had color in the 40s, then you would...
No. You've never watched The Uninvited?
No, but I'm sorry.
Do you have a DVD player?
No.
All right, you and Alex are going to watch it with us one night.
We'll watch it.
It is stylized. It's not noir, but it's spooky. It's spooky. It's creaking doors. It's the dark.
Are you telling me the mother running down the hallway that's extending and extending and she's trying to get to her kids that's not fucking freaky?
No.
Sliding down into the muddy pool of skeletons?
No.
Liar.
No.
You want to go swimming with skeletons and dead bodies floating up at you?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, you'd be fucking Jeff. Oh my God, Jeff!
Don't know what language that was, but no. I mean, it's shocking, but to me, scary is the dark. And that's where I give Ridley Scott props with Alien.
Yes,
Alien was in
movie.
The dark. You heard things over your... Would you like to wrap yourself up like a UPS box? What the fuck are you doing with that shawl?
I'm warm. I'm happy.
Oh, okay. But Alien, jeez. You just saw... things quickly. What the fuck? Oh my God. Quickly in the film. That's spooky as shit. That's building. And I love my Spielberg. Love him.
I love
that. But that didn't scare me. That didn't scare me.
I liked the Poltergeist as I did. And the second one we saw in the theaters, my parents took me. And I remember when the boy opened up the broom closet at the grandma's house and was looking for stuff and all the brooms fell out on him. I jumped like 5 feet. Must have been like 10, maybe 11.
I'm surprised you had cognitive emotions then.
Well, I'd been trying to get into the TV for years, but they never came out and took me, so I just had to watch
that
it.
That poor little girl died.
Half of the cast members are dead from that show.
Well,
the sister died.
The sister died?
Yeah, there's a lot. There were a lot of deaths on that making of
fate.
That movie. And
no,
yes, she died
fate.
Of some kind of...
Well, she was young.
Terrible disease. Yeah, and you could tell in the last one she was all puffy in the face.
Okay, you know what? Once again, you had to bring it down to babies with no brains.
I can bring it down one step further.
Oh.
Actually, well, yeah.
What? Don't.
Yeah, so...
Are you
know,
seriously?
I'm
you're gonna
a jack bring... of all trades.
I know. You are going to tell this.
I am. It's not an Erin in the Hood,
no,
really, because...
I know. This isn't funny.
I'm just going to tell it. I have to listen to your cancer stories.
Yeah, but mine have an upbeat, total Pollyanna ending. I put the charm in cancer.
Do you?
Yes.
What is that, like a bracelet coming out for that,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, fuck you
David
for looking
charm?
Into my...
Anyway.
I get it over. It's a very sweet thing you're doing.
But I'm upset. I'm going to want to express myself.
I know,
now.
But our audience is going to go... Oh, no.
Yes, that's right.
Here she goes.
Yes, here I go.
Oh,
and you're
no.
all fucking stuck and have no choice but to listen. So here it is. I do know. Now, you see, now I'm not going to tell my story.
No. I'm sorry.
No.
I was trying to
find. You pushed too far. Too far. You went too far.
No.
Maybe later.
Too far. No.
You, maybe
no,
later.
Tell,
no, maybe
it's a,
later.
No, it's a very sweet thing.
I have time.
No.
I have 12 minutes left. I will find time in 12 minutes to tell my story.
Are you saying to me we have only
yes.
12 minutes left to the program?
Yep.
Where did the time go?
You were spent the whole time in the corner talking to yourself. I tried very hard to pull you into the conversations. It was very difficult.
Would you like to tell your story?
I do.
Do tell it, because it's wonderful and it shows you what an incredible heart you have.
Well, I'm a traveling notary and I go to
Wait a
hospitals.
Minute. Do you have like a covered
Wagon? What are you asking me?
Well, no, with a mule. Wait. With a mule and then this man on the side going, traveling notary, republic. I mean, notary public. Is it no, pub, no, notary public. No, what the fuck is the
I'm
title?
I'm not going to talk to you anymore.
No.
No, notary. That's too done. Not telling my story now.
No, stop
nope.
it.
Nope.
You're a you. I didn't know there were such things as traveling notary publics. So
let's move on.
No.
Yes. We're moving on.
That was a sweet joke, and that what you're going to
no,
do is
no.
sweet.
Let's keep it moving.
All right, fine. I hate you right
now. I hate you too.
No, and I just think it's awful what you're doing to us in front of everybody.
Yeah, you should be ashamed of yourself.
No, it's not. If name tags told the truth.
We're doing that again?
Betty Ann Thurston, museum curator.
Curator?
Betty Ann Thurston, museum curator. I think every person entering my museum is dumber than shit.
I don't have any.
I don't care.
Oh, okay.
I can do this by myself.
Go ahead. I've been waiting for you to participate this whole time.
Would
it's
you
about
like,
time you come in the end.
Would you? Do you have any poetry?
I have one.
Oh, well then you know what? Let me change gears.
Why don't you get on to that gear, yeah?
Ladies and gentlemen, since Erin won't tell us her heartwarming story about how wonderful of a human being she is as a traveling notary public, we are now going to bring you terrible poetry.
Untitled.
Oh, you bitch.
Don't call me, I'll call you. Don't touch me, I'll touch you. Pass me a drink and I'll sing you a tune. I'm a bar playing pianist. How about you? End scene.
Don't touch me. I'm a bar. I'm confused.
Why?
It wasn't terrible, but what story did you tell?
I'm a bar playing pianist. That was my story. Don't touch me. Don't call me. Pass me a drink and I'll sing you a tune. Because that's what I do.
Well, you are not the piano man.
No, that's Billy Joel.
Thank you.
You're
and
welcome.
There's only
I'm
one
taller.
Billy Joel.
I'm taller than my... Well,
you're taller than Billy Joel?
I think so.
Billy Joel's short?
I heard he was. He goes on Midget Airlines.
Stop it, he yes. does.
He plays a tiny guitar.
He plays the piano, okay? Christie Brinkley. She scared me. She continues
Brinkley.
To
Brinkley.
She continues to scare me.
You don't really see much about Christie Brinkley.
Oh.
Anyway, terrible
anybody
poetry
who's
yourself.
Anybody who's that blonde and always, hi, I'm happy because I'm wearing Frumpke's nuclear tampons.
Nuclear tampons?
Well, that's what that thing.
Oh, my God. That's like radioactive vaginas.
Okay, huh. Wait a minute. Okay.
Do you have a poem?
David's terrible poetry. Combination. Willow, willow, bending in the wind. The warm breeze separates my legs. As I lie beneath you, almighty tree, with your majestic long branches, creep down to my awaiting crotch. Nature and burning flesh become one and create a new life. End scene.
I didn't like it.
It was beautiful.
It was ugly.
It was a willow tree.
Why is your
trees fucking...
always got to open up from everything, you whore?
Because that's why I like willow trees. Now, see, that did not
okay.
specify whether it was male or female.
No. You were trans
well,
tree.
Kind of. What?
Trans tree.
Trans tree? There was nothing trans about the willow. The willow has branches.
It does have branches.
Droopy branches.
Uh-huh.
There's no trans.
The wind's
about...
blowing, your legs are wide
right.
open. Yeah.
So it could have been a little ivy up the butt.
You waiting for a cowboy just rolling by? What's happening over
I
there?
I don't think cowboys and
terrible.
Willow tree.
Your poem was terrible. And it's raining.
It's not. It's not. You're looking. What you're seeing is the
okay. Stop.
The eaves,
before you embarrass yourself.
The eaves of the house.
Completely embarrass yourself.
It's the eaves of the house.
It's not.
It's dripping.
It is not.
It's dripping.
Further than that, though, too.
I'm looking,
and why does it matter anyway? But it's raining. David's in denial.
Ladies and gentlemen. Oh no! Wait. I forgot. Hold on. See, you're messing me up. No, it's not funny. Oh, stop with the fucking.
I'm starting to figure these buttons out.
All right. What else?
That's it.
How much? What time do we have?
55 minutes.
Oh, come on. No fucking way we're quitting at 55 minutes.
We're quitting.
No, we're not.
We're fucking quitting at 55 minutes.
Light that baby up.
We're quitting.
No.
I'm done leaving right now.
No.
I'm going to go.
Don't. No.
I'm going to go.
Okay, I'll wait for her to find the doorbell.
You can take the whole 5 minutes and shove it up your ass.
Well, wasn't that nice? Oh, shit. You know what? I'll save it for the next show. It's
what?
A long story.
What?
Of how I went to LensCrafter yesterday to buy moist towelettes.
How long could your story be about LensCrafter?
It was a guy who was there. My buddy Donna, who is the manager there. I went. Here's my mental state. I went there to buy three boxes of the moist towelettes to wipe your glasses with. I like using them. I went in, walked in, picked up three boxes, bought.
Never thought to look at them.
Purchased them.
Yeah.
Came home, looked at them, and went, "You asshole!
You bought tampons."
No. Everything has to have something to do with your vagina.
What was the tampon kind of day with that commercial?
Stringless. Boneless.
Stringless lens wipes.
Willow fuck. That should be a name of a drink.
Willow
hey,
fuck?
Bartender, can I have a willow fuck? And that's
it's
my...
like sex on the beach?
No. Anyway, I bought dry cloths that you have to have the spray, and I don't like that. It doesn't work as well. And I bought three boxes of those.
What are you going to do now, David?
I'm going to go back to my little grass shack back in Ikikunu, Hawaii, where the coochie 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 girls come down from the aisle. Go on, say something.
I don't want to. How can I follow that gem up, David?
Oh, it's true. Yeah. There was a gentleman there.
Yeah.
And well, I'm going back and I'm going to exchange them. And I'm also going to bring them all hoodies. Everybody just came out. How are you doing? How are you feeling? It's just amazing. To have that connection.
Yeah.
And that's why I want you to close the show with that incredible deed you're going to do today.
All right. Are you done with your jokes, though?
All done.
All right, fine. Here's my good deed of the day.
Your good deed of the day.
I am a traveling notary.
Correct. I did not know there was a difference.
Yes. And I go to hospitals or retirement homes or people's homes where they can't get out of their homes that need notaries.
Correct.
And I usually charge a fee for that.
Of course. You don't do it for free.
No. But I got a call yesterday from a couple whose daughter is dying. She's my age, a few years older than me.
Okay.
And she has cancer, and I have to go notarize her will today. And I'm upset about it.
Yes.
Because I feel sad.
Yeah.
The parents are 76 years old, and it's like now they're going to bury
their daughter. Yep.
Yeah. And I can't charge. So she said, "You have to charge." I said, "I do what my heart tells me. I cannot charge you."
And that's what's so nice about you.
Well, you know, I feel bad. So.
Yes. No.
That was my sad story.
Yeah. No, I know.
And I'll cry. I'm going to cry.
Well, cry now. Don't cry in front of the mother and
father. I'm going to probably cry in front of everybody.
No.
Yep.
What did I tell you?
You said cry in front of everybody and stamp the wrong papers.
I said, don't. Be strong. You're a good person. And why don't you tell you what? To make them not feel this, talk about babies that are born without brains.
I'll burst spring balloons. Get well soon.
Oh, God, Erin.
For the babies.
No. Oh, now my Erin's back. I'm going to go and bring balloons to say get well soon. Oh, my God. And you yelled at me. You should see her. She is 8 shades of red. Her chest is pure red.
But it's not.
It is. That is one of the darkest fucking humor that's brilliant. That's a skit. That's a skit where you come into...
Wait, can I just tell you? There was this dead raccoon in Poughkeepsie where I lived. This is a true story.
Okay.
Many years ago. We're going back 16 years. So We tied a balloon on it that said "Get well soon." She slipped it, and we took a picture
Stop
of it.
Stop it!
And I swear to God, a week later, it circled on Facebook. That picture, people reused it all over the place, and people were putting pictures up of them, like doing it on dead deer, on dead, like everything, just dead chickens. Get well soon, balloons.
See, I would have cried at the raccoon. You got a get well balloon.
Well, we didn't go get it. We already had one in the car.
Who has a get well soon?
Somebody wasn't feeling good. We were bringing balloons and a flower.
How old were you?
This was 16 years ago.
You were in your 30s.
Yes.
My God. I could blame it on adolescence.
I didn't hit the raccoon. It was already dead.
You defiled Rocky Raccoon's body with a get well soon balloon when the dude's dead. Oh my God.
Yeah, he did not, in fact, get
there
well soon.
There are doors, windows, shades that are opening right now on you. And, well, that was a door that closed on you.
On that note.
Yeah. You know what, Erin?
Yeah.
This is where I do mean it. You better calm the fuck down.
I need to calm the fuck down.
Yeah, like now, Erin. Say
right
to me.
This minute.
Say to me, David.
David.
I.
Have to.
Calm the fuck down.
Calm the fuck down.
Erin and David out.
With David and Erin.
Calm the fuck down.
Calm the fuck down.
With David and Erin.
With David and Erin.